And should Labour MP Keith Vaz be standing again?
I hope so. I think Keith has made a great contribution in Parliament over a long time. The decision about his suspension has been made, and I'm very sad that's happened, though I understand the reasons for it and clearly...
Why do you hope that a man who offered to buy cocaine for male prostitutes should be standing as an MP again for your party?
It will be for the voters in his constituency to make that decision about whether he will continue to represent them as MP. What I would say is Keith has done a great job as a Member of Parliament for a long time.
I thought he's been too unwell for many years since this event in 2016. He apparently was been too unwell to attend any hearings and things. I'm not sure he could have done the job of being a local MP very well if he's unable to attend meetings to discuss his behaviour.
He's been the MP for a long time, and over the course of that period, he's done a great job, and I think he's entitled to a lot of respect for the work that he's done over the whole of that time.
I'm genuinely quite... I'm quite dumbstruck that you're of that view. You think this man is a fit and proper person to be a Member of Parliament?
Well, he was a great chair of the Home Affairs Select Committee. He's done all kinds of very important roles in Parliament, and a lot of people have benefited as a result, and I think that needs to be taken full account of in assessing Keith's contribution.
Should Keith Vaz be standing again as a Labour MP?
No, I think in light of all these revelations and in the judgment of the Standards Committee, Keith Vaz should not seek re-election as the Labour candidate in his constituency.
And if he sought it, should he be turned down?
I certainly think today the Labour leadership ought to withdraw the whip. This is not the type of candidate we want standing for Labour, and certainly I think many of his constituents will not want him to be standing as their MP.
Stephen Timms made the point, Bobby Freeman, that it's up to local people to make that decision. But of course, people may already have made that decision. His argument was, this man has been an MP for many years, been a good MP for many years, and sort of, I suppose, one just overlooks someone pretending to be a washing machine salesman and offering cocaine to prostitutes.
Well, you know what? If it were just the cocaine, I could maybe just about see that argument. I wouldn't necessarily agree with it. But the real issue here is obstructing a parliamentary report and the commission's work. So he has obstructed this inquiry. He has blatantly acted in a manner that is not fit for an MP, acted with what seems from the report to be a lack of probity. And it's been suggested that he should be suspended. It's been recommended that he be suspended for 6 months. So the people of, I think it's Leicester East, wouldn't even have an MP for 6 months because he wouldn't be allowed in the House of Commons. Apart from Dennis McShane, who did then resign, who they suggested a suspension of a year. It's one of the longest suspensions almost since the war.
Okay.
So I have to say, it is so disingenuous. And hearing that kind of interview, you think this is why people think politicians are out of touch, because you've got someone defending his own, a member of the political class, defending someone who, if you were in any other job,
you'd be kicked out. Well, look, let's talk to Andrew Bridgen. He's Conservative MP. We'll talk about Brexit issues with him as well in just a few moments. But Andrew Bridgen, you, of course, were the MP who made the original formal complaint about Keith Vaz after these stories emerged in the tabloid newspapers. Should Keith Vaz be standing again as an MP?
No. Sorry, Juliet. No, he's not fit to be a Member of Parliament. And my seat is about 15 miles from Leicester East in North Leicestershire. I hear a lot of things that go on in Keith Vaz's seat, and I'm not willing to discuss them here, but I would suggest that what he's been found guilty of by standards is at the very mild end of his misdemeanours. So I think Labour Party should suspend him, the whip from him immediately. He's not fit to stand. Hopefully this is the end of the line for Keith Vaz. I can assure you he's been a very malign influence on both East Midlands local politics and national politics for a very long time.
What do you mean by a malign influence? Bearing in mind the libel laws of this country.
Well, I'm trying to bear that in mind. I think some of the things that go on in his constituency I think they will come to light once he's gone. I think once his power base has been taken away, I think he's someone who a lot of people are very, very scared of, and that's why he's managed to get away with so much for so long. I think he's a very intimidating character. People who've generally stood up against him in his political past, whether that's people from the Labour Party or the Conservative Party, he has sought to destroy them, and he's been fairly successful at that. But I think the boot's on the other foot now, and I think as his political power wanes, I think you're going to find a lot of people coming forward to tell you things that people really do know about Keith Buzz that haven't come out. What's quite worrying, Julia, is I've been hearing rumours from Leicester for a very long time now, for over 6 months, that he's actually grooming his daughter to take over the seat to keep the family firm going.
OK, well, obviously, we haven't got Keith Faz on the show to reply to any of those suggestions and insinuations. So, obviously, I need to make that clear that I'm sure he would be, at this point, denying any of the hints that you are suggesting at the current time. I feel I need to say that, Andrew. But in terms of bringing Parliament into disrepute, given that just on the bare bones of what this parliamentary committee was about, the fact that it took 3 years for us to get any resolution because he said he was too unwell to attend any of these hearings and to give evidence and the like, and that's why it was sort of kicked onto the back. Well, you know, he was on the back burner for quite a few years before there was a proper investigation. And the fact of the actual resolution that he did offer to buy cocaine for two rent boys after posing as a washing machine salesman, does this bring Parliament into disrepute, the fact that he's still right now an MP and still has the whip of one of our major parties?
Well, ultimately, he was voted in by the people of Leicester East at the last election. And I was aware, I can actually disclose now, that the Standards Commissioner met with me a week before summer recess and said that she'd completed her report into the investigation of Keith Vaz. What was clear was she wouldn't show me the report at that stage. I saw the report like everyone else at 2 o'clock yesterday when it went public. But she did say to me that you've complained many times about how long this investigation's taken. But I hope that, you know, when you do read the report, you'll see why it's taken so long. And you read the report and it's Keith Faz's modus operandi. And indeed, many people who are guilty will seek to deflect, confuse and to delay. And Keith Faz did that. And it's also what he did in 2001 when he was investigated by the then Standards Commissioner, Philkin. And he was actually suspended from the House for a month back in 2001. It wasn't for anything he'd done. It was actually for not cooperating with the investigation at that time. The big mistake the House made in 2001 was not suspending him when he came back after a month, when he still wouldn't cooperate with that investigation. And that's what he's done. And he has sought to use his own delay tactics. I think Keith was really hoping that he could have delayed this report for another week, in which case we may have had a general election and it would have all disappeared.
It is absolutely extraordinary, this story. And I know, you know, there's other stuff going on.
but
this is Keith Faz is a former government minister. He was chairman of the Home Affairs Select Committee. He's been one of the most powerful people in the Labour Party. The report, if you've got a spare half an hour this morning, read the full report from the Standards Committee. It is extraordinary. Keith Faz claims that the two rent boys he invited round to his house were, in fact, interior decorators coming round to advise him on doing up his flat, who, of course, he invited round at 11:30 on a Saturday night. It's Keith Faz's explanation. He also says that he drank a glass of water and he then can't remember anything else afterwards. He says he basically has amnesia. He can't remember what happened at the meeting with the interior decorators. An explanation that actually the report says is literally incredible. It's just not credible. I
like the point that he gave so many different excuses and reasons for things and explanations, and that the committee pointed out that well, they couldn't all be true because they were all mutually exclusive. So we knew that.
Yeah.
It has been something of a hilarious report. Except, you know, we are talking about someone who's supposedly an honourable member of the House of Commons and could possibly still stand and hasn't had the whip taken away extraordinarily.
No, and that, you know, that points very much to Keith Faz's long-standing position in the Labour Party. He was a big fundraiser for lots of Labour MPs and that sort of thing. He does, you know, his tentacles are right across the Labour Party.
What happens to his seat? Because if there's an election in December and he's suspended, how does that work? Yeah, I mean, I think, well, first of all, Labour, I was talking to sources in the Labour Party, and they were going to suspend the whip from him. But last night he admitted himself to hospital, which means that they can't really do that because it's quite insensitive, quite a difficult moment.
You certainly wouldn't want the Labour Party to appear to be insensitive in any way.
No, but, he's done this before, and of course we have to be sensitive about, the problems he's going through privately, but he's done this before to, and some might say to try and avoid punishment. But if he is suspended from the party, then he cannot stand in the election that we're expecting on the 11th of December.
Then does that mean they'd have to find another candidate for his seat?
Yeah. Yes, okay. Correct. So he'd be no longer an MP. But I'm also hearing that on Monday they're scheduling the vote in the House of Commons. Or usually it's just nodded through the recommendation to ban him for 6 months. There might be a vote on it, but by Monday we should hear that he's got that suspension confirmed, and then that would basically trigger a petition in the constituency to have a by-election. So that would be another route to get him out. But yes. It sounds like the end of the road for him.
It does, doesn't it? And so it should be, really. Yeah. I mean, here's the verdict, and I quote, Vaz disregarded the law by expressing a willingness to supply cocaine to two prostitutes, was evasive during the investigation, and caused significant damage to the reputation and integrity of the House of Commons. I mean, in some ways, he's lucky he's not facing charges, isn't he?
Well, yeah, I know. The police have looked into this twice. I mean, he's used every tactic in the book, really, to try and avoid any kind of inquiry and punishment. But, more than 3 years on, it now looks like very much the end of the road. And because of this general election, it looks like he will just face the end of his parliamentary career, really. It shouldn't just be like default position where he just can't stand again. He should face, he should be accountable for what he has done
I can't imagine, Matt, if it was you or I that had got involved in this kind of behaviour, that we'd just be walking around. I would have thought that the police, who have done two probes into it, what happened, and have come up with nothing, would not be doing that with anybody else. And also, the House of Commons itself has come under a bit of criticism, not just for the protection of Keith Vaz's affairs, but also for the protection of John Bercow's sort of bullying. And there's I think there was parliamentary privilege used by John Bercow back in 2018 after some newspapers and the BBC tried to get information on Keith Vaz and on some allegations about bullying inside the House of Commons.
Well, John Bercow and Keith Vaz are known to be to each other, and it's just.
Oh, we just lost you there.
Sorry, can you hear me now?
Yeah, you're back. Yeah.
Right, that. It just shows you what's wrong with the House of Commons. It's a closed shop, a very tight club. And to be honest, when John Bercow finally steps down as Speaker and MP on Thursday, I think it will be a very good day for this House of Commons, because there are so many MPs in this place who are avoiding and escaping justice for actions, however serious, from minor to very serious allegations that they face. And if those allegations are come to nothing, then fair enough. But they why should they not face up to these allegations when any other member of the public should? And the reason is because they're MPs, and it's quite shocking, having worked in this building for 5 years, to know so many allegations that have gone completely that no one has gone after those allegations.